Today on Flying, Fishing, and Food, we fly down to Beaufort, North Carolina, and have an excellent dinner at 34 degrees north. Okay, so we're flying down to Moorhead, or to Beaufort, and we're going to have lunch at a restaurant called 34 North.
Dinner.
Yeah, that's right. Flying with my son Matthew and his friend Scarlett. You guys look up.
Wave.
So we're at 7,000 feet, and we are in cruise, and we're above the clouds, and we've got... we're 85 miles from Moorhead, Beaufort, and about 29 minutes. So Gretchen's communicating. So.
Yeah, 2862, contact Washington Center 124.02.
Flying over New Bern right now, and that's the Pamlico Sound of the Neuse River. And we'll fly over Cherry Point. And right
Cherry Point approach, Cessna 66728.
Right into Moorhead.
4 miles west of New Bern. Request flight following to practice area 3 Echo.
Moorhead traffic, Bonanza Niner Delta Victor. We are 9 miles from the west of the airport, inbound on 14, full stop landing.
Sure, that frequency, because that's not what he said. That's why I said that. He gave us a different frequency, but that was
it.
Okay, the frequency he gave us was if we were canceling IFR with someone else. That's right.
Right.
Okay. All right. Okay. So we're about
approach flaps.
I'm gonna announce 5 miles out.
Yep.
5 miles long. Final.
You're coming down.
1-3
green. Traffic stream is over the port. We're gonna be flying upwind 14, entering a traffic pattern.
14. Okay.
Okay.
So, go ahead.
Tell them where you are.
5 miles on a long final for 14.
Right.
Moorhead traffic. This is Bonanza Niner Delta Victor. About 5 miles on a long final for 14. Moorhead traffic. Hopefully they heard that.
Here you go, take that.
And bumper traffic stream is going to be turning left downwind, 14, bumper.
Get warm.
Yeah. Whew, look at those waves. I want to go swimming.
We head over to the Beaufort Hotel for dinner. The Beaufort Hotel is located on a site that used to be a menhaden processing plant. Menhaden processing started in North Carolina shortly after the Civil War, though it wasn't until the 1890s that menhaden factories began netting some real success. Menhaden were caught in massive nets and then brought to Beaufort for processing. Reduction of menhaden generated products that were ground into fertilizer or minced into meal for cat food and dog food. This fish was also cooked and squeezed into extract for their oils in use in paint, soap, and omega-3 dietary supplements. The North Carolina menhaden fishery flourished up until the late 1960s. Beaufort was no exception. Beaufort Fisheries, Inc. would process about 110,000 pounds of fish meal an hour from start to finish. This site was not one of the nicer sides of Beaufort. To prepare the site for development of the boathouse at Front Street Village, 530 tons of waste and debris, 915,000 tons of steel, 5,100 gallons of oil were recycled during the demolition of this property. Over 10,000 tons of concrete were recycled and reused for construction as a part of the design. In 2019, the Beaufort Hotel was built on this property and has emerged as a leader in promoting environmental responsibility. To start the meal, we had the shrimp appetizer and the caprese salad. Scarlett ordered the hamburger, which looked wonderful. Matthew got the filet with mushrooms. Gretchen got the shrimp and grits. And I got the grouper over risotto. All were excellent.
Can you do slow motion?
We head over to downtown Beaufort. Beaufort may have begun as a small fishing and whaling community on the edge of the calm, sound waters of the open Atlantic Ocean, but it soon blossomed and became one of the richest communities in the new state of North Carolina. Not all of the new worldly travelers who landed in Beaufort were desirable ones. However, as the Beaufort's reputation as a successful port town grew, so did the influx of the famed pirates, including Blackbeard, Calico Jack, and Annie Bonney, one of the country's first female pirates. We finish up a great dinner, head back to the airport for our trip home. We want to thank everyone at 34 Degrees North for a fantastic dinner. We take off on runway 21. It puts us out over Beaufort, over the Sound, and out over Atlantic Beach. As we turn back to the west, we head over Morehead City and watch the beautiful sunset.
This evening at
34 degrees north,
and it was wonderful. We took some video of it. Now we're headed back. Gretchen's communicating, and we are headed back to Henderson. The sunset is in the west.
Gorgeous.
We are just crossing over Cherry Point, and we've got about 121 miles to go back home. We'll do a night landing, and we will be home soon. It's a lot faster than driving.
That's right.
Coming up on 7,000 feet. We're cleared to 8. The radios are quiet, which is nice at night. So we are just crossing over Cherry Point, headed back to Henderson, HNZ, at 8,000 feet. We are in cruise, quiet on the radio, which is really nice. We got our passengers in the back here.
Yeah.
Say hello.
Say wave. Turn my lights.
Turn them on. Okay, that's good.
You're supposed to do seven. That's what I've always been told. Is that not true?
There you go. You got them on.
Oh, yeah. All right. Henderson traffic, Bonanza 9 or Delta Victor, about 5 miles to the south, coming in to DuCross midfield, entering left downwind for 6. Henderson traffic. Announcing just in case. There's somebody up there, way up there. Who else was doing that?
Okay, Gumps.
Gas. Fullest tank.
Fullest tank.
Undercarriage. Mixture's full rich.
Fullest tank.
Fullest tank.
Okay.
Mixture full rich.
Mixture's full
both
rich.
Tanks are the same, basically. Yeah. Power. Prop. Switches and safety. Undercarriage down shortly. Autopilot
once
off.
Once we cross, autopilot is off.
All right.
Call.
All right. That we're about to, yeah. Henderson traffic, Bonanza 9 or Delta Victor, 2 miles south, going to cross midfield, entering left downwind for 6. Henderson traffic.
How does it go?
Victor turning final 6. Henderson traffic. All right. There we go. This is what I wanted right here. Up on us, didn't I? I was videoing the whole thing though. That's a good bounce.